GSF, but just want to step back and talk about the philosophy of F. F is important to us in designation as well. The LS400, the original flagship vehicle, internally we refer to as flagship one, so F from that standpoint. As Brian mentioned, also the Fuji Speedway, where a lot of the F development has occurred. So F kind of has a meaning for us. The other thing is, too, it has three elements to it, sound, response, and limitless power feel. So those are sort of the guiding principles with the F development. And Yaguchi-san is actually is the father of F, if you will. He was the one that started the ISF, most recently the RCF, and then, of course, the GSF. So he's the kind of founding father. He was the one that kind of started that Skunk Works project and has inherited the F. So it's very true and near and dear to him, if you will. And of course, we have somebody by the name of Akio Toyota that also loves performance, so that definitely helps. So just kind of to recap, again, the F pedigree began with the ISF, as Brian mentioned. It then also continued with development with the ISF CCSR vehicle, circuit racing, which basically, again, was kind of a hot or a test bed, if you will, for the RCF and, of course, ultimately the GSF as we have now. And then the LFA, that was really, if you will, a stake in the ground that I think we as a brand said we do have the capability in engineering to be able to create a supercar like we did. And it truly was Akio Toyota that brought that, that gave the car a green light. And then the Gazoo Lexus LFA Codex, that was his racing team, if you will, that again continued with the development. And many a time he was out, and you probably heard and seen him out in Nürburgring driving the Fuji Speedway. You know, he lives and breathes performance. And I think it's that elevated and actually kind of helped Lexus in general, even non-F sport or F vehicles, to really kind of have more passion, excitement, connection with the driver. So then, you know, last year this time, I think a lot of familiar faces, RCF, we were experiencing that vehicle at the track Monticello and down in Nashville and New Orleans. So again, that was kind of the replacement, if you will, with the ISF as that vehicle sunset, RCF came into the mix. But now it's the GSF that is the successor, if you will, to the ISF. This vehicle is going to bring a much different aspect because it's a little more practical in a sense. You know, it's performance, but also with the four doors, it allows for a little more versatility than what the RCF made. So drivetrain, and as I go through this, I'm going to hit on GSF and then into RCF. So of course, it's going to be some similarities with this information, but it has a 5-liter V8 engine, 32-valve dual overhead cam, putting out 467 horsepower and 389 pound-feet of torque. 0 to 60 time on the vehicle is 4.5 seconds, and top speed is 168 miles per hour. Not that fuel economy is maybe so important to some people, but a pretty impressive 16 miles per gallon city and 24 highway. One of the things that this engine, like the RCF, has is it has electronic variable valve timing on the intake, so it actually allows for late closing of the intake valve that basically kind of takes the engine from being the 5-liter to the equivalent of a 4.2-liter. So again, that's in more normal driving conditions as you're driving up and down a freeway or what have you. So in essence, makes it a more driver and more fuel-efficient vehicle, but you know, I don't think people are buying a GSF or an RCF for fuel efficiency necessarily. The exhaust system, of course, you know, the car needs a great engine, but also has to sound great. So we are utilizing our diagonally stacked quad diffusers. We first saw that with the ISF, continued with the RCF, and of course the GSF. Making sure, of course, it has a great exhaust note is important. With that, though, too, this vehicle does have active sound control, and it features two speakers, one embedded in the dash, and then one in the rear shelf area. Separate dedicated speakers. The one up front is going to actually help, I would say amplify, will kind of help layer and enhance the sounds coming from the engine itself. The rear speaker will actually then enhance the exhaust note. So again, really kind of, you're going to hear natural sounds, but it's going to take it to that next level. Because again, performance is all about not just driving it, but what you hear and you know, collectively that kind of completes the package. Does feature an 8-speed sport direct shift transmission, so of course it has automatic mode, and then manual mode with the paddle shifters or using the actual gear shift itself.